Guangzhou, Guangzhou, also known as Canton, is the capital and most populous city of the province of Guangdong in southern China. On the Pearl River about north-northwest of Hong Kong and north of Macau, Guangzhou has a history of over 2,200 years and was a major terminus of the Maritime Silk Road, and continues to serve as a major port and transportation hub, as well as one of China's three largest cities. Guangzhou is at the heart of the most populous built-up metropolitan area in mainland China that extends into the neighboring cities of Foshan, Dongguan, Zhongshan, and Shenzhen, forming one of the largest urban agglomerations on the planet. Administratively, the city holds sub-provincial status and is one of China's nine national central cities. In 2015, the city's administrative area was estimated to have a population of 13,501,100. Guangzhou is ranked as an alpha global city. There is a rapidly increasing number of foreign temporary residents and immigrants from Southeast Asia, the Middle East, Eastern Europe, and Africa. This has led to it being dubbed the capital of the Third World. The domestic migrant population from other provinces of China in Guangzhou was 40% of the city's total population in 2008. Together with Shanghai, Beijing, and Shenzhen, Guangzhou has one of the most expensive real estate markets in China. In the late 1990s and early 2000s, nationals of sub-Saharan Africa who had initially settled in the Middle East and other parts of Southeast Asia moved in unprecedented numbers to Guangzhou, China in response to the 1997-98 Asian financial crisis. Long the only Chinese port accessible to most foreign traders, Guangzhou fell to the British during the First Opium War. No longer enjoying a monopoly after the war, it lost trade to other ports such as Hong Kong and Shanghai, but continued to serve as a major entrepot. In modern commerce, Guangzhou is best known for its annual Canton Fair, the oldest and largest trade fair in China. For the three consecutive years 2013 to 2015, Forbes ranked Guangzhou as the best commercial city on the Chinese mainland. Guangzhou is the pinyin romanization of the Chinese name, which was simplified in mainland China too in the 1950s. The name of the city is taken from the ancient Guang province, Guangzhou, after it had become the prefecture's seat of government, which is how some other Chinese cities, including Hangzhou, Suzhou, and Fuzhou got their names. The character or which also appears in the names of the provinces Guangdong and Guangxi, together called the Liangguang, means broad or expansive and refers to the intention to dispense imperial grace broadly in the region with the founding of County of Guangxin and Han Dynasty. Before acquiring its current name, the town was known as Panyu, a name still borne by one of Guangzhou's districts not far from the main city. The origin of the name is still uncertain, with 11 various explanations being offered, including that it may have referred to two local mountains. The city has also sometimes been known as Guangzhoufu or Guangfu after its status as the capital of a prefecture. From this latter name, Guangzhou was known to medieval Persians such as Al-Masudi and Ibn Khordad Bey as Kanfu. Under the southern Han, the city was renamed Xingwang. The Chinese abbreviation for Guangzhou is, although the abbreviation on car license plates, as with the rest of the province, is, after its nickname Rice City. The city has long borne the nickname or from the five stones at the old Temple of the Five Immortals said to have been the sheep or goats ridden by the Taoist culture heroes credited with introducing rice cultivation to the area around the time of the city's foundation. The former name City of the Immortals came from the same story. The more recent is usually taken as a simple reference to the area's fine greenery. The English name Canton derived from Portuguese or comma muddling of dialectical pronunciations of Guangdong, for example, Hakka Kong Tung. Although it originally and chiefly applied to the walled city, it was occasionally conflated with Guangdong by some authors. It was adopted as the postal map romanization of Guangzhou and remained in common use until the gradual adoption of pinyin. As an adjective, it is still used in describing the people, language, cuisine and culture of Guangzhou and the surrounding Liangguang region. The 19th century name derived from Nanjing dialect of Mandarin and the town's status as a prefectural capital. A settlement now known as Nanwusheng was present in the area by. Some traditional Chinese histories place Nanwusheng's founding during the reign of Jian, King of Zhou from 314 to 256. It was said to have consisted of little more than a stockade of bamboo and mud. Panyu was established on the east bank of the Pearl River in 214 to serve as a base for the Qin Empire's first veiled invasion of the Beiyue lands in southern China. Legendary accounts claim the soldiers at Panyu were so vigilant that they did not remove their armor for 3 years. Upon the fall of the Qin, General Zhao Tuo established his own kingdom of Nanyue and made Panyu its capital in 204. It remained independent through the Chu Han contention, although Zhao negotiated recognition of his independence in exchange for his nominal submission to the Han in 196. Archaeological evidence shows that Panyu was an expansive commercial center. In addition to items from central China, archaeologists have found remains originating from Southeast Asia, India, and even Africa. Zhao Tuo was succeeded by Zhao Mo and then Zhao Yinki. Upon Zhao Yinki's death in, his younger son Zhao Xing was named as his successor in violation of Chinese primogeniture. By his Chinese mother, the Empress Dowager Zhu, had prevailed upon him to submit Nanyue as a formal part of the Han Empire. The native Prime Minister Lu Jia launched a coup, killing Han ambassadors along with the king, his mother, and their supporters. A successful ambush then annihilated a Han force which had been sent to arrest him. The enraged Emperor Wu launched a massive river and seaborne invasion. Six armies under Lu Bod and Yang Pu took Panyu and annexed Nanyue by the end of 111. Incorporated into the Han Empire, Panyu became a provincial capital. In 226, it became the seat of Guang Prefecture, which gave it its modern name. The Old Book of Tang described Guangzhou as an important port in southern China. Direct routes connected the Middle East and China, as shown in records of a Chinese prisoner returning home from Iraq 12 years after his capture at Talas. Relations were not always peaceful. Muslims sacked the city on 30 October 758 and were massacred by the Chinese rebel Huang Zhao in 878, along with the city's Jews, Christians, and Parsis. Amid the five dynasties and 10 kingdoms that followed the collapse of the Tang dynasty, the later Liang governor Liu Yan used his base at Panyu to establish a Great Yue or Southern Han Empire, which lasted from 917 to 971. The region enjoyed considerable cultural and economic success in this period. From the 10th to 12th century, there are records that the large foreign communities were not exclusively male, but included Persian women. Guangzhou was visited by the Moroccan traveler Ibn Battuta during his 14th century journeying around the world. He detailed the process by which the Chinese constructed their large ships in the port's shipyards. Shortly after the Hongwu Emperor's declaration of the Ming Dynasty, he reversed his earlier support of foreign trade and imposed the first of a series of seabans, Haijin. These banned private foreign trade upon penalty of death for the merchant and exile for his family and neighbors. The Yuan era maritime intendancies of Guangzhou, Chuanzhou, and Ningbo were closed in 1384 and legal trade became limited to the tribute delegations Seino or by official representatives of foreign governments. Following the Portuguese conquest of Malacca, Rafael Barestrello traveled to Guangzhou as a passenger on a native junk in 1516. His report induced Fernão Pires de Andrade to sail to the city with 8 ships the next year, but de Andrade's exploration was understood as spying and his brother Simão and others began attempting to monopolize trade, enslaving Chinese women and children, engaging in piracy, and fortifying the island of Tamao. Rumors even circulated that Portuguese were eating the children. The Guangzhou administration was charged with driving them off. They bested the Portuguese at the Battle of Tunman and in Shikau Bay, held the diplomatic mission hostage in a failed attempt to pressure the restoration of the Sultan of Malacca, who had been accounted a Ming vassal, and, after placing them in Kangs and keeping them for most of a year, ultimately executed 23 by Ling Qi. With the help of local pirates, the Folangji then carried out smuggling at Macau, Lampacau, and Island, now Shangchuan, until Leonel de Souza legalized their trade with bribes to Admiral Wangbo, and the 1554 Luso-Chinese Accord. The Portuguese undertook not to raise fortifications and to pay customs dues. 3 years later, after providing the Chinese with assistance suppressing their former pirate allies, the Portuguese were permitted to warehouse their goods at Macau instead of Guangzhou itself. After the fall of Fuzhou in October 1646, the Longwu Emperor's brother Zhu Yuyue fled by sea to Guangzhou. On 11 December, he declared himself the Xia Emperor, borrowing his imperial regalia from local theater troops. He led a successful offense against his cousin Zhu Yulong but was deposed and executed on January 20, 1647 when the Ming turncoat Li Jiangdong sacked the city on behalf of the Qing. The Qing became somewhat more open to foreign trade after gaining control of Taiwan in 1683. The Portuguese from Macau and Spaniards from Manila returned, as did private Muslim, Armenian, and English traders. From 1699 to 1714, the French and British East India Companies sent a ship or two each year. The Austrian Ostend General India Company arrived in 1717, the Dutch East India Company in 1729, the Danish Asiatic Company in 1731, and the Swedish East India Company the next year. These were joined by the occasional Prussian or Trieste Company vessel. The first independent American ship arrived in 1784 and the first colonial Australian one in 1788. By that time, Guangzhou was one of the world's great ports, organized under the Canton system. The main exports were tea and porcelain. As a meeting place of merchants from all over the world, Guangzhou became a major contributor to the rise of the modern global economy. In the 19th century, most of the city's buildings were still only one or two stories. The major structures were the plain minaret of the Haisheng Mosque, the flower pagoda of the Temple of the Six Banyan Trees, and the guard tower known as the five-story pagoda. The northern hills, since urbanized, were bare and covered with traditional graves. The brick city walls were about in circumference, high, and wide. Its eight main gates and two water gates all held guards during the day and were closed at night. The wall rose to incorporate a hill on its northern side and was surrounded on the other three by a moat which, along with the canals, functioned as the city's sewer, emptied daily by the river's tides. A partition wall with four gates divided the northern old town from the southern new town closer to the river, the suburb of Zigan, Westgate, stretched beyond and the boats of fishers, traders, and Tangka, boat people, almost entirely concealed the riverbank for about. It was common for homes to have a storefront facing the street and to treat their courtyards as a kind of warehouse. The city was part of a network of signal towers so effective that messages could be relayed to Beijing, about away, in less than 24 hours. The Canton system was maintained until the outbreak of the First Opium War in 1839. Following a series of battles in the Pearl River Delta, the British captured Guangzhou itself on March 18, 1841. The Second Battle of Canton was fought 2 months later. Following the Qing Empire's 1842 treaty with Great Britain, Guangzhou lost its privileged trade status as more and more treaty ports were opened to more and more countries, usually including extraterritorial enclaves. Amid the decline of Qing prestige and the chaos of the Taiping Rebellion, the Punti and Hakka waged a series of clan wars from 1855 to 1867 in which 1 million people died. The concession for the Canton-Hankou Railway was awarded to the American China Development Company in 1898. It completed its branch line west to Foshan and San Shui before being engulfed in a diplomatic crisis after a Belgian consortium bought a controlling interest and the Qing cancelled its concession. J.P. Morgan was awarded millions in damages and the line to Wuchang wasn't completed until 1936 and a unified Beijing-Guangzhou Railway waited until the completion of Wuhan's Yangtze River Bridge in 1957. During the late Qing dynasty, Guangzhou was the site of failed revolts such as the uprisings of 1895 and 1911 to overthrow the Qing. The 72 rebels whose bodies were found after the latter uprising are remembered and honored as the city's 72 martyrs in the Huanghuagang, Yellow Flower Mound, mausoleum. All these failed revolutionary attempts would eventually lead to the Xinhai Revolution, which successfully overthrew the Qing dynasty to establish a new Han Chinese Republic. Influenced by the ideas of Peter Kropotkin, anarchist newspapers began to circulate whilst the tea houses formed anarcho-syndicalist unions throughout the 1910s. Eventually, the anarchists were able to seize control of the city for a number of years under the banner of the KMT and create a large anarchist commune which was described as heavenly by outsiders. However, the KMT soon cracked down on anarchist members and they sought refuge in the city before it was retaken by government soldiers. After the assassination of Song Zhaoren and Yuan Shikai's attempts to remove the Nationalist Party of China from power, the leader of Guangdong Hu Hanmin joined the 1913 Second Revolution against him but was forced to flee to Japan with Sun Yat-sen after its failure. The city came under national spotlight again in 1917, when Prime Minister Duan Jiawei's abrogation of the constitution triggered the constitutional protection movement. Sun Yat-sen came to head the Guangzhou military government supported by the members of the dissolved parliament and the southwestern warlords. The Guangzhou government fell apart as the warlords withdrew their support. Sun fled to Shanghai in November 1918 until the Guangdong warlord Chen Jiangming restored him in October 1920 during the Yugi Wars. On June 16, 1922, Sun was ousted in a coup and fled on the warship Yongfeng after Chen sided with the Vili clique's Beijing government. In the following months, Sun mounted a counterattack into Guangdong by rallying supporters from Yunnan and Guangxi, and in January established a government in the city for the third time. From 1923 to 1926, Sun and the Kuomintang used the city as a base to prosecute a renewed revolution in China by conquering the warlords in the north. Although Sun was previously dependent on opportunistic warlords who hosted him in the city, with the leadership of Chiang Kai-shek, the KMT developed its own military power to serve its ambition. The Canton years saw the evolution of the KMT into a revolutionary movement with a strong military focus and ideological commitment, setting the tone of the KMT rule of China beyond 1927. In 1924, the KMT made the momentous decision to ally with the Communist Party and the USSR. With Soviet help, KMT reorganized itself along the Leninist line and adopted a pro-labor and pro-peasant stance. The Kuomintang-CCP cooperation was confirmed in the first Congress of the KMT and the Communists were instructed to join the KMT. The Allied government set up the Peasant Movement Training Institute in the city, of which Mao Zedong was a director for only term. Sun and his military commander Chiang used Soviet funds and weapons to build an armed force staffed by Communist commissars, training its cadres in the Whampoa Military Academy. In August, the fledgling army suppressed the Canton Merchants' Corps uprising. The next year, the anti-imperialist May 30th movement swept the country, and the KMT government called for strikes in Canton and Hong Kong. The tensions of the massive strikes and protests led to the Shaky Massacre. After the death of Sun Yat-sen in 1925, the mood was changing in the party toward the communists. In August, the left-wing KMT leader Liao Hongkai was assassinated and the right-wing leader Hu Hanmin, the suspected mastermind, was exiled to the Soviet Union, leaving the pro-communist Wang Jingwei in charge. Opposing communist encroachment, the right-wing Western Hills group vowed to expel the communists from the KMT. The Canton coup on March 20, 1926 saw Chiang solidify his control over the nationalists and their army against Wang Jingwei, the party's left wing, its communist allies, and its Soviet advisors. By May, he had ended civilian control of the military and begun his northern expedition against the warlords off north. Its success led to the split of the KMT between Wuhan and Nanking and the purge of the communists in the Shanghai Massacre. Immediately afterwards, Canton joined the purge under the auspice of Li Jishan, resulting in the arrest of communists and the suspension of left-wing KMT apparatuses and labor groups. Later in 1927, when Zhang Feikui, a general supportive of the Wuhan faction, seized Canton and installed Wang Jingwei's faction in the city, the communists saw an opening and launched the Guangzhou Uprising. Prominent communist military leaders Yi Ting and Yi Jianying led the failed defense of the city. Soon, control of the city reverted to Li Jishan. Li was deposed in the war between Jiang and Guangxi clique. By 1929, Chen Yitang had established himself as the powerholder of Guangdong. In 1931, he threw his weight behind the anti-Jiang schism by hosting a separate nationalist government in Guangzhou. Opposing Jiang's alleged dictatorship, the separatists included KMT leaders like Wang Jingwei, Sun Fo and others from diverse factions. The peace negotiations amidst the armed standoff led to the Fourth National Congress of Kuomintang being held separately by three factions in Nanjing, Shanghai, and Canton. Resigning all his posts, Jiang pulled off a political compromise that reunited all factions. While the inter-party division was resolved, Chen kept his power until he was defeated by Jiang in 1936. During World War II, the Canton operation subjected the city to Japanese occupation by the end of December 1938. Amid the closing months of the Chinese Civil War, Guangzhou briefly served as the capital of the Republic of China after the taking of Nanjing by the PLA in April 1949. The People's Liberation Army entered the city on October 14, 1949. Amid a massive exodus to Hong Kong and Macau, the nationalists blew up the Haiju Bridge across the Pearl River in retreat. The Cultural Revolution had a large effect on the city, with much of its temples, churches and other monuments destroyed during this chaotic period. The People's Republic of China initiated building projects including new housing on the banks of the Pearl River to adjust the city's boat people to life on land. Since the 1980s, the city's close proximity to Hong Kong and Shenzhen and its ties to overseas Chinese have made it one of the first beneficiaries of China's opening up under Deng Xiaoping. Beneficial tax reforms in the 1990s have also helped the city's industrialization and development. district. The municipality was expanded in the year 2000, with Huadu and Panyu joining the city as urban districts and Songhua and Songcheng as more rural counties. The former districts of Dongshan and Fangkun were abolished in 2005, merged into Yuexu and Liwan respectively. The city acquired Nansha and Luogang. The former was carved out of Panyu, the latter from parts of Baiyun, Tianhe, Songcheng, and an exclave within Huangpu. The National People's Congress approved a development plan for the Pearl River Delta in January 2009. On March 19 the same year, the Guangzhou and Foshan municipal governments agreed to establish a framework to merge the two cities. In 2014, Luogang merged into Huangpu and both Songhua and Zhengcheng counties were upgraded to districts. Guangzhou was then the most populous consolidated district-governed city in China until Beijing overtook it the next year. The old town of Guangzhou was nearby in mountain on the east bank of the Pearl River, Ujiang, about from its junction with the South China Sea and about below its head of navigation. It commanded the rich alluvial plain of the Pearl River Delta, with its connection to the sea protected at the Hunan Strait. The present city spans on both sides of the river from to longitude and to latitude in south-central Guangdong. The Pearl is the third largest river of China. Baiyun Mountain is now locally referred to as the city's lung. The elevation of the prefecture generally increases from southwest to northeast, with mountains forming the backbone of the city and the ocean comprising front. Diantang Peak, Heavenly Peak, is the highest point of elevation at above sea level. There are 47 different types of minerals and also 820 ore fields in Guangzhou, including 18 large and medium-sized oil deposits. The major minerals are granite, cement limestone, ceramic clay, potassium, albite, salt mine, Muravelite, nepheline, cyanite, fluorite, marble, mineral water, and geothermal mineral water. Since Guangzhou is located in the water-rich area of southern China, it has a wide water area with lots of rivers and water systems, accounting for 10% of the total land area. The rivers and streams improve the landscape and keep the ecological environment of the city stable. Despite being located just south of the Tropic of Cancer, Guangzhou has a humid subtropical climate, Kupin CFA, influenced by the East Asian monsoon. Summers are wet with high temperatures, high humidity, and a high heat index. Winters are mild and comparatively dry. Guangzhou has a lengthy monsoon season, spanning from April through September. Monthly averages range from in January to in July, while the annual mean is autumn, from October to December, is very moderate, cool and windy, and is the best travel time. The relative humidity is approximately 68%. Whereas annual rainfall in the metropolitan area is over. With monthly percent possible sunshine ranging from 17% in March and April to 52% in November, the city receives 1,628 hours of bright sunshine annually, considerably less than nearby Shenzhen and Hong Kong. Extreme temperatures have ranged from 2. The last recorded snowfall in the city was on January 24, 2016, 87 years after the second last recorded snowfall. Guangzhou is a sub-provincial city. It has direct jurisdiction over 11 districts. Guangzhou is the main manufacturing hub of the Pearl River Delta, one of mainland China's leading commercial and manufacturing regions. In 2017, the GDP reached 2,150 billion yen, 318 billion US dollars, per capita was 150,678 yen, US $22,317. Guangzhou is considered one of the most prosperous cities in China. But due to rapid industrialization, it is also considered one of the most polluted cities. The Canton Fair, formerly the China Import and Export Fair, is held every year in April and October by the Ministry of Trade. Inaugurated in the spring of 1957, the fair is a major event for the city. It is the trade fair with the longest history, highest level, largest scale in China. From the 104th session onwards, the fair moved to the new Guangzhou International Convention and Exhibition Center, Inkzhou, from the older complex in Liyue. The GISAC is served by two stations on Metro Line 8 and three stations on Tram Line THC1. Since the 104th session, the Canton Fair has been arranged in three phases instead of two phases. Guangzhou Peugeot Automobile Company produced the Peugeot 504 and Peugeot 505 automobiles from 1989 to 1997. The export processing zone was founded in 2005. Its total planned area is. It is located in Nansha District and it belongs to the provincial capital, Guangzhou. The major industries encouraged in the zone include automobile assembly, biotechnology and heavy industry. It is situated, 70 minutes drive, south of Guangzhou by an international airport and close to Nansha port. It also has the advantage of Guangzhou Metro Line 4, which is being extended to Nansha Ferry Terminal. The zone was founded in 1992. It is located in the east of Huangpu District and near to Guangzhou Economic and Technological Development Zone. It is also very close to Guangzhou by an airport. The major industries encouraged in the zone include international trade, logistics, processing and computer software. The 2010 census found Guangzhou's population to be 12.78 million. It was estimated at 13,080,500, with 11,264,800 urban residents. Its population density is thus around 1,800 people per kilometer. The built-up area of the Guangzhou proper connects directly to several other cities. The built-up area of the Pearl River Delta Economic Zone covers around and has been estimated to house 22 million people, including Guangzhou's nine urban districts: Shenzhen, 5.36 meters, Dongguan, 3.22 meters, Zhongshan, 3.12 meters, most of Foshan, 2.2 meters, Jiangmen, 1.82 meters, Zhuhai, 890 km, and Huizhou's Huyang District, 760 km. The total population of this agglomeration is over 28 million after including the population of the adjacent Hong Kong Special Administrative Region. The area's fast-growing economy and high demand for labor has produced a huge floating population of migrant workers. Up to 10 million migrants reside in the area at least 6 months each year. In 2008, about 5 million of Guangzhou's permanent residents were Hakulis migrants. Most of Guangzhou's population is Han Chinese. Almost all of the local Cantonese people speak Cantonese as their first language, while most migrants speak forms of Mandarin. In 2010, each language was the native tongue of roughly half of the city's population, although minor but substantial numbers speak other varieties as well. In 2018, He Hefeng of the South China Morning Post stated that younger residents have increasingly favored using Mandarin instead of Cantonese in their daily lives, causing their Cantonese-speaking grandparents and parents to use Mandarin to communicate with them. He Hefeng stated that factors included local authorities discouraging the use of Cantonese in schools and the rise in prestige of Mandarin-speaking Shenzhen. As with elsewhere in the People's Republic of China, the household registration system, Hakou, limits migrants' access to residences, educational institutions and other public benefits. In May 2014, legally employed migrants in Guangzhou were permitted to receive a Hakou card allowing them to marry and obtain permission for their pregnancies in the city, rather than having to return to their official hometowns as previously. Historically, the Cantonese people have made up a sizable part of the 19th and 20th century Chinese diaspora and many overseas Chinese have ties to Guangzhou. This is particularly true in the United States, Canada, and Australia. Demographically, the only significant immigration into China has been by overseas Chinese, but Guangzhou sees many foreign tourists, workers, and residents from the usual locations such as the United States. Notably, it is also home to thousands of African immigrants, including people from Nigeria, Angola and the Democratic Republic of Congo. The encompassing metropolitan area was estimated by the OECD, Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, to have a population of 25 million. When the first line of the Guangzhou Metro opened in 1997, Guangzhou was the fourth city in mainland China to have an underground railway system, behind Beijing, Tianjin, and Shanghai. Currently the metro network is made up of 13 lines, covering a total length of. A long-term plan is to make the city's metro system expand to over by 2020 with 15 lines in operation. In addition to the metro system there is also the Haiju tram line which opened on December 31, 2014. The Guangzhou Bus Rapid Transit, GBRT, system which was introduced in 2010 along Zhongshan Road. It has several connections to the metro and is the world's largest bus rapid transit system with 1 million passenger trips daily. It handles 26,900 PPHPD during the peak hour capacity, second only to the Transmilenio-BRT system in Bogota. The system averages one bus every 10 seconds or 350 per hour in a single direction and contains the world's longest BRT stations, around including bridges. In the 19th century, city already boasted over 600 long, straight streets, these were mostly paved but still very narrow. In June 1919, Work began on demolishing the city wall to make way for wider streets and the development of tramways. The demolition took 3 years in total. In 2009, it was reported that all 9,424 buses and 17,695 taxis in Guangzhou would be operating on LPG fuel by 2010 to promote clean energy for transport and improve the environment ahead of the 2010 Asian Games, which were held in the city. At present, Guangzhou is the city that uses the most LPG-fueled vehicles in the world, and at the end of 2006, 6,500 buses and 16,000 taxis were using LPG, taking up 85% of all buses and taxis. Effective January 1, 2007, the municipal government banned motorcycles in Guangdong's urban areas. Motorcycles found violating the ban are confiscated. The Guangzhou Traffic Bureau claimed to have reported reduced traffic problems and accidents in the downtown area since the ban. Guangzhou's main airport is the Baiyun International Airport in Baiyun District. It opened on August 5, 2004. This airport is the second busiest airport in terms of traffic movements in China. It replaced the old Baiyun International Airport, which was very close to the city center but failed to meet the city's fast-growing air traffic demand. The old Baiyun International Airport was in operation for 72 years. Guangzhou Baiyun International Airport now has three runways, with two more planned. The Terminal 2 has opened on April 26, 2018. Another airport located in Zhongshan District is under planning. Guangzhou is served by Hong Kong International Airport. Ticketed passengers can take ferries from the Lian Huashan Ferry Terminal and Nansha Ferry Port in Nansha District to the Hia Sky Pier. There are also coach bus services connecting Guangzhou with Hia. Guangzhou is the terminus of the Beijing Guangzhou, Guangzhou Shenzhen, Guangzhou Ming and Guangzhou Mizhou-Shantou conventional speed railways. In late 2009, the Wuhan-Guangzhou high-speed railway started service, with multiple unit trains covering at a top speed of. In December 2014, the Guiyang-Guangzhou high-speed railway and Nanning-Guangzhou railway began service with trains running at top speeds of and, respectively. The Guangdong through train departs from the Guangzhou East Railway Station and arrives at the Hong Hom KCR station in Kowloon, Hong Kong. The route is approximately in length and the ride takes less than 2 hours. Frequent coach services are also provided with coaches departing every day from different locations, mostly major hotels, around the city. A number of regional railways radiating from Guangzhou started operating, such as the Guangzhou-Zhuhai Intercity Railway and the Guangzhou-Jiaoqing Intercity Railway. There are daily high-speed catamaran services between Nansha Ferry Terminal and Lian Huashan Ferry Terminal in Guangzhou and the Hong Kong-China Ferry Terminal, as well as between Nansha Ferry Terminal and Macau Ferry Pier in Hong Kong. Within China, the culture of the Cantonese people is a subset of the larger southern or Lingnan cultural areas. Notable aspects of Guangzhou's cultural heritage include the Guangzhou Opera House and Symphony Orchestra also perform classical Western music and Chinese compositions in their style. Cantonese music is a traditional style of Chinese instrumental music, while Cantopop is the local form of pop music and rock and roll which developed from neighboring Hong Kong. Qing era Guangzhou had around 124 religious pavilions, halls, and temples. Today, in addition to the Buddhist Association, Guangzhou also has a Taoist Association, a Jewish community, and a history with Christianity and Islam. Taoism and Chinese folk religion are still represented at a few of the city's temples. Among the most important is the Temple of the Five Immortals, honoring the five immortals credited with introducing rice cultivation at the foundation of the city. The five rams they rode were supposed to have turned into stones upon their departure and gave the city several of its nicknames. Another place of worship is the city god temple. Guangzhou, like most of southern China, is also notably observant concerning ancestral veneration during occasions like the tomb sweeping and ghost festivals. Buddhism is the most prominent religion in Guangzhou. The Qiqi Temple was founded in 233 from the estate of a Wu official. It is said to comprise the residence of Zhao Jiandai, the last of the Nan Yue kings, and has been known as the Guangxiao Temple, Temple of Bright Filial Piety, since the Ming. The missionary Bodhidharma is traditionally said to have visited Panyu during the Liu Song or Liang dynasties, 5th or 6th century. Around 520, Emperor Wu of the Liang ordered the construction of the Bawangian Temple and the Shilai Monastery to store the relics of Cambodian Buddhist saints which had been brought to the city and to house the monks beginning to assemble there. The Baowangian is now known as the Temple of the Six Banyan Trees, after a famous poem composed by Su Shi after a visit during the Northern Song. The Shilai Monastery was renamed the Hualan Temple, Flowery Forest Temple, after its reconstruction during the Qing. The temples were damaged by both the Republican campaign to promote education with temple property and the Maoist Cultural Revolution, but have been renovated since the opening up that began in the 1980s. The Ocean Banner Temple on Henan Island, once famous in the West as the only tourist spot in Guangzhou accessible to foreigners, has been reopened as the Huitong Monastery. Nestorian Christians first arrived in China via the Overland Silk Road, but suffered during Emperor Wuzong's 845 persecution and were essentially extinct by the year 1000. The Qing era ban on foreigners limited missionaries until it was abolished following the First Opium War, although the Protestant Robert Morrison was able to perform some work through his service with the British factory. The Catholic Archdiocese of Guangzhou is housed at Guangzhou's Sacred Heart Cathedral, known locally as the Stone House. A Gothic Revival edifice which was built by hand from 1861 to 1888 under French direction, its original Latin and French stained glass windows were destroyed during the wars and amid the Cultural Revolution, they have since been replaced by English owns. The Canton Christian College, 1888, and Hackett Medical College for Women, 1902, were both founded by missionaries and now form part of Guangzhou's Lingnan. Since the opening up of China in the 1980s, there has been renewed interest in Christianity, but Guangzhou maintains pressure on underground churches which avoid registration with government officials. The Catholic Archbishop Dominic Tang was imprisoned without trial for 22 years, but his present successor is recognized by both the Vatican and China's Patriotic Church. Guangzhou has had a Muslim community since very early in the history of Islam. The native or nativized adherents of the faith are known as the Hui. Haisheng Mosque was probably built during the Tang Dynasty. Muslims sacked the city in 758 and were massacred by the Chinese rebel Huangzhou in 878, along with the Jews, Christians, and Parsis. The modern city includes numerous halal restaurants. The 18,000-seat Guangzhou International Sports Arena will be one of the venues for the 2019 FIBA Basketball World Cup. From 12 November 27, 2010, Guangzhou hosted the 16th Asian Games. The same year, it hosted the first Asian Para Games from December 12 to 19. Combined, these were the largest sporting events the city ever hosted. Guangzhou also hosted the following major sporting events. Current professional sports clubs based in Guangzhou include in the early 2010s, Guangzhou Evergrande Toubao FC has risen to be a powerhouse in association football in China, having won 7 consecutive national titles between 2011 and 2017. The team has also won the AFC Champions League in 2013 and 2015. The club has competed at the 2013 and 2015 FIFA Club World Cup, where it lost 3-0 in the semi-final stage to the 2012-13 UEFA Champions League winners FC Bayern Munich and the 2014-15 UEFA Champions League winners FC Barcelona, respectively. The 8 views of Ram City are Guangzhou's 8 most famous tourist attractions. They have varied over time since the Song Dynasty, with some being named or demoted by emperors. The following modern list was chosen through public appraisal in 2011. Guangzhou attracts more than 100 million visitors each year. There are many tourist attractions, including in every district there are many shopping areas where people can walk on the sidewalks, however most of them are not set as pedestrian streets. The popular pedestrian streets are. There are many malls and shopping centers in Guangzhou. The majority of the new malls are located in the Tianhe district. Guangzhou has 2 local radio stations, the provincial radio Guangdong and the municipal radio Guangzhou. Together they broadcast in more than a dozen channels. The primary language of both stations is Cantonese. Traditionally only one channel of radio Guangdong is dedicated to Mandarin Chinese. However, in recent years there has been an increase in Mandarin programs on most Cantonese channels. Radio stations from cities around Guangzhou mainly broadcast in Cantonese and can be received in different parts of the city, depending on the radio station's locations and transmission power. The Beijing-based China National Radio also broadcasts Mandarin programs in the city. Radio Guangdong has a 30-minute weekly English program, Guangdong Today, which is broadcast globally through the World Radio Network. Daily English news programs are also broadcast by Radio Guangdong. Guangzhou has some of the best Chinese language newspapers and magazines in mainland China, most of which are published by three major newspaper groups in the city, the Guangzhou Daily Press Group, Nanfeng Press Corporation, and the Yangcheng Evening News Group. The two leading newspapers of the city are Guangzhou Daily and Southern Metropolis Daily. The former, with a circulation of 1.8 million, has been China's most successful newspaper for 14 years in terms of advertising revenue, while Southern Metropolis Daily is considered one of the most liberal newspapers in mainland China. In addition to Guangzhou's Chinese-language publications, there are few English magazines and newspapers. The most successful is That's Guangzhou, which started more than a decade ago and has since blossomed into That's PRD, producing expatriate magazines in Beijing and Shanghai as well. It also produces In the Red. The Guangzhou Higher Education Mega Center, also known as Guangzhou University Town, is a large tertiary education complex located in the southeast suburbs of Guangzhou. It occupies the entirety of Shaanxi Island in Panya District, covering an area of about. The complex accommodates campuses from 10 higher education institutions and can eventually accommodate up to 200,000 students, 20,000 teachers, and 50,000 staff. The Guangzhou Higher Education Mega Center Higher Education Campuses. Guangzhou's other fully accredited and degree-granting universities and colleges include. The two main comprehensive libraries are Guangzhou Library and Sun Yat-sen Library of Guangdong Province. Guangzhou Library is a public library in Guangzhou. The library has moved to a new building in Ujiang New Town, which fully opened on June 23, 2013. Sun Yat-sen Library of Guangdong Province has the largest collection of ancient books in southern China. Guangzhou currently maintains sister city agreements with the following foreign cities. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.